Welcome friends, welcome back to another lecture on the Teacher on Demand series. This lecture has been requested by one of my followers and this topic will be on the Bombay blood group. Now, before we understand the Bombay blood group, I request you to kindly go through a few of my videos before which deal with the ABO blood group system. Briefly, the RBCs express various kinds of proteins or carbohydrates on their cell membrane. These can be used for classifying the blood RBCs into various blood groups. The ABO blood group system is a group of system based on carbohydrate antigens. They derived from a parent carbohydrate, the H antigen. Chemically, this is the structure of the H antigen. This H antigen is then acted upon by two enzymes. Some people have the N-acetyl galactose transferase enzyme, which attaches a molecule of N-acetyl galactose to the H antigen to form the A antigen. When N-acetyl galactose is attached to the H antigen, we get the A antigen. There are people who have another enzyme called the galactose transferase, which attaches a galactose molecule, converting the H antigen into the B antigen. So, if the enzyme is N-acetyl galactose transferase, this RBCs will have the H antigen. Some of the H antigens get converted to the A antigen, so this RBCs express the H antigen and the A antigen. Similarly, if the enzyme is galactose transferase, some of the H antigen gets converted to the B antigen, so a person with the blood group of B will express H antigens and B antigens. There are people who have both the enzymes, so we'll have the H antigen, the A antigen and the B antigen, and these people will be grouped AB. There are yet another category of people who don't have either of the enzymes and they'll be expressing only the H antigen. Since they don't express the A antigen or the B antigen, these people will be classified as O blood group. Now, let's understand. A blood group person has the H antigen and the A antigen. The B blood group has the H antigen and the B antigen. The O blood group has only the H antigens. And the AB blood group has the H antigen, the A antigen and the B antigen. Now, please note that all the blood groups of ABO system express the H antigen. What are antibodies? Antibodies are formed in response to an antigen. If the antigen is present, then it is considered a self and we won't have antibodies against the same antigen. So, a person with the A blood group, since he is expressing the H antigen and the A antigen, he'll have only antibodies against B. Similarly, a person with the B blood group has got the H antigens and the B antigen, so it expresses only antibodies against A. O blood group expresses only the H antigen. They don't have the A antigen or the B antigen, so they express anti-A and anti-B. If the concentrations of this anti-A and anti-B in the blood is very high, these group of people are called dangerous donors. Now, the AB blood group has got H antigen, A antigen and B antigen. Therefore, these people don't have any antibodies directed against the ABO blood group system. Good. If we've understood this, the next question is, what is Bombay blood group and how do we diagnose it? Well, it was detected by Dr. Bende in Bombay in 1952 in a Parsi community. It was found that some person required blood and whatever blood group they tried to give him, he cross-reacted with it. There was something more to it which the doctors are not able to understand. What they knew was that he could receive blood only from close relatives and not from any of the other ABO blood group system. Further investigations revealed that this person did not express even the H antigen. Okay, this is a blood group, O blood group, where there is the H antigen, there is no A and B antigen. In the Bombay blood group, we don't have the H antigen, so there is no substrate which can be acted upon to produce the A or the B antigen. So in effect, these people do not have the H antigen, do not have the A antigen or the B antigen. Let's get back to this. The antigens which are expressed on the cells of a Bombay blood group are none. They don't have the A antigen, they do not have the B antigen, and they do not have the H antigen. Because none of these antigens are present, the antibodies in the sera will include anti-A, anti-B, and anti-H also. How is the Bombay blood group different from the O blood group? In the Bombay blood group, we do not have the H antigen. In the O blood group sample, we have the H antigen. Because the H antigen is not present in the Bombay blood group, they have anti-H antibodies present, which is not present in the O blood group. Very good. No H antigens. So what exactly is the problem? When the person receives blood, he cannot receive blood from the A or the B blood group. He cannot receive blood from the O blood group also. Why? Because the O blood, he can't receive blood from the A and the B blood group because he has anti-A, anti-B. He cannot receive blood from the O blood group also. Why? Because the O blood group has H antigens and the Bombay blood group persons has antibodies against the H antigens also. So this will cross-react even with O blood group. So O blood group cannot be given to him. Neither can A nor can B. The only blood group that he can receive is another person of the Bombay blood group who also doesn't have the H antigen. What happens when he donates? When the Bombay blood group donates blood, there is no problem because he's got no antigens in his cell, so the cells will be accepted by any of the recipient. However, since the antibody titers are, he's got anti-A, anti-B and anti-H in his blood, if the titers are high, then they will be considered as dangerous donors, similar to the dangerous donors of the O blood group. Now, when do we suspect a person of Bombay blood group? Ideally, when we do the normal screening of a person for various blood groups, these people will be detected to be O blood group. We use anti-A, anti-B and anti-AB. So in all these three reagents, these people will not react because they don't have the A, B antigens. So they will be labeled as O. Then, are all O positives HO, a Bombay blood group? No. Whenever we get an O blood group, we are supposed to use a specific anti-sera, the anti-H anti-sera. What do we expect? When I take a O blood cell, a cell which has been labeled as O, and I treat it with anti-H antibodies, will I get an agglutination or will I not get an agglutination? Presence of agglutination, is it a positive or a negative reaction? Okay, let's go by basic logic. Does the Bombay blood group have H antigens? No. So when I use an anti-H antibody, will I expect agglutination? No. If I get agglutination with anti-H antibodies, then I'm dealing with an O blood group. If I don't get an agglutination with the anti-H antibody, that means this RBC doesn't even have the H antigen. So this RBC is an Bombay blood group. A Bombay blood group will be characterized by a O blood group which does not even react with anti-H anti-sera. There's another method to do it, and this is called the sera grouping of cells. In sera grouping, we take pooled O cells from various donors, different donors who have got O blood group, wash their RBCs and can make a pooled panel of O positive cells and put this O positive cell in the patient's sera. If the patient was O blood group, then he wouldn't be having the anti-H antibodies and there will be no agglutination. But if the person is a Bombay blood group, their sera will have anti-H antibodies. This anti-H antibodies will react with the H antigens of the pooled O cells and then we will get agglutination. So if we put pooled O cells in the sera of a Bombay blood group patient, we will get agglutination. And this test is very simple and does not require costly, expensive reagents like the anti-H anti-sera. So either way, if we get an O patient, O blood group person, we are supposed to test it with anti-H anti-sera or do the sera grouping to confirm that the person we are dealing with is not a Bombay blood group. So to summarize, Bombay blood group is a group in which the H antigen is not present in the surface of the RBC, and because there is no H antigen, there will be no A or B antigen. These people have antibodies in their sera, anti-A, anti-B and anti-H also. They cannot receive blood from any of the ABO blood group because all of them express the H antigen. These people are usually mislabeled as O blood group unless specifically looked for. How do we look at it? We can use the anti-H anti-sera, or we can do sera grouping. Thank you very much. Please feel free to contact me at my email ID arunharith@gmail.com. I would also be interested in getting your feedbacks about my lecture. You can also request lectures on any topic pertaining to laboratory medicine, and I'll be very happy to make it for you. Thank you.